Henry!
Whoa, that's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set them straight. Do you think you can handle that? I'm sorry it's not in the job description.
Like, kick the shit out of him sort of straight?
No. Jesus, no.
What? I'm not a cop. It's not like I've got a rule book over here.
Just make sure they don't do it again. Take their shit.
All right, fine.
Don't feed anyone a knuckle sandwich. Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right. There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234. It's actually that for all of them.
Secure.
Shut up.
people just stuff these things with old food? That's how you get bears.
Those boxes are bear-proof. I wouldn't worry about it.
Hey, there's a snack in here. I'm probably gonna eat it.
Where's that?
I'm at the cash box. I've got an overgrown trail here.
Yeah, that'll happen.
So I'm screwed when it comes to getting past it?
Mm-hmm. Screwed until you clear it yourself, yeah.
Great. Well, if I come across some tools, I'll add groundskeeping to my ever-increasing list of responsibilities. This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
What about shitty boss is gonna get me killed hill?
Oh, is that Absorca Indian? Maybe Creek?
That's actually English for not in my job description. How do you expect me to get down this?
Well, did you get that rope?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, just lash it to something nearby and take it slow.
Hey, I'm going the right way if I'm at the shale slide, right? Toward the fireworks?
You're not lost. Those fireworks are going off to the west of you. It's down the slide and across the meadow, okay?
No! Oh. Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
My shitty boss almost got me killed.
First, your boss is a delight. Secondly, Jesus. What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Hey, there's a tie-off point off here just a little way from the shale slide.
Well, you ready to get back on that horse, huh?
Well, I can't go any further is what I'm saying.
That heads south down to the creek, but you should be able to get to the lake just by continuing west. Without any, you know, mountaineering.
All right.
It's a long summer. You can explore later.
It is a hell of a nice camping spot down here by the lake.
I haven't been down there in years, but yeah, Jonesy Lake area is perfect.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
The idiots down at the lake?
Yeah, them. I just found where they're hanging out. They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
Oh, look, they decided to have a campfire, too.
You know, they color-coded the fire danger signs in case people were illiterate. But I guess that doesn't take into account just plain stupid, does it?
They left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Oh shit, ferret or Irish. Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
What, you don't like a cold Musquelite on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than these fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure. Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people Well, what if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
There are, panties?
There are what?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
I found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Enjoy dealing with that.
I know you guys are setting up bottle rockets out here, okay?
How? Because you're hiding in the bushes, spying on us?
Give him a break, Lily. He probably hasn't seen boobs in 20 years.
He's probably still a virgin.
Why do guys think it's all right to just stare at girls?
Took all of your stuff. Fireworks, whiskey, you name it.
What? You dick!
Also, setting off fireworks out here isn't just stupid, it's illegal.
Yeah, so is stealing, asshole.
That's so fucking bogus.
You're gonna pay for that.
Can we just get out of here?
Ew, totally.
You're gross.
You're just some sad man out in the woods.
Hey, Did that go okay?
I hope they drown.
Yow!
I don't think anyone would mourn a couple of future arsonists.
Just gonna go ahead and not log that as a threat?
Thanks.
But seriously, though, thanks for dealing with it.
So there's no noise ordinances or rules out here?
No. But that music I hear makes a good case for them.
Yeah, no kidding. Hey, I'm back near that big rock outcropping, but not sure how to get back.
I'd head west, back towards the lake, and then turn north towards the canyon.
What the hell?
I'm doing a crossword and I figured out the theme. It's homonyms. Pears, pears, pears. The clue was couples peeling fruit. Anyway, hope you're having a good afternoon.
Thanks. Okay, so from these rocks, where do I go again?
Go back towards the lake, turn north, and east through the canyon. There should be a trail at the far east side of it.
Just push. any chance of those kids getting a disease in this lake, like diphtheria or consumption or...
Consumption? Not if they're not 19th century chimney sweeps, no.
You know, whatever.
I mean, if they drank a bunch, Giardia maybe, but probably not this time of year.
Well, that's too bad. Well, this lake does seem like a good spot to swim, even if the last people to do so were assholes.
Yeah, right now, though, it's all snowmelt, so you'll freeze your balls off. But as hot as it's been, maybe that's a fair trade.
Starting to feel like it. Hey, there's a trail to Two Forks Tower down here near the lake.
Yeah, that's your tower.
So I should go this way.
Well, you're not climbing back up that slide. A bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know, I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff.
It's fine.
I'll keep that sort of a thing to a minimum. Anyway, let me know when you get back to your lookout.
I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home and try not to get hit by lightning.
I got hit by lightning when I was 9 years old, so I'm safe. It's not gonna strike twice and all that.
Well, there was an old lookout named Roy Sullivan who got hit by lightning 7 times.
I don't like the sound of that.
Yeah, well, if it makes you feel any better, it wasn't what killed him.
What killed him?
Suicide. Would you believe?
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon?
Thunder Canyon?
I didn't name it. But in the cave, I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
So, it looks like the path leads through the cave.
Back in the cave, huh? Man, I don't need to lose another lookout in there.
Another lookout?
They go in, they never come out.
So this is another one of your jokes.
It is, yep.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Makes sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
That's too bad. I used to go caving in Colorado a lot with someone. Would be really nice to pick that back up.
Fond memories, huh?
Big time. I'll keep an eye out for those keys.
Don't hold your breath.
Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but, you know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime. It's So this generator is all the power I've got out here?
Yep. It doesn't go through much gas, and, well, you don't have much in the way of electronics, so...
What about my hairdryer?
Oh, I'm sorry. You might just have to make peace with frizzy locks.
I could never. So it's, just the outhouse, then, in terms of going to the bathroom?
You're a man, Henry. You can go wherever you want. Well, number one, at least. And, full disclosure, I pee wherever I want as well.
The outhouse is gross today, and it will be gross forever.
Well, all the bacteria die during the winter, so anything you smell and don't like in there is your own brand, just so you know.
Ugh. Well, then I'm a disgusting animal. My typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You write?
Yeah, look, the wind? No. How the hell...
You should get inside.
Fuck me. Someone broke in.
They what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker!
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
That was fast.
Yeah, well, do you have any idea who could have done this?
I did probably piss off the girls at the lake. Ugh, fuck them.
Well, I'll have the Rangers keep an eye out for a couple of young women and question any they find. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some, what, violent campers? Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. We won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
I need you to feel safe out here.
Just point me to the Forest Service weapons cache and I'll feel safer than the Pope in his little car.
Yeah, someone made the choice years ago that leaving people with infinite amounts of alone time and a gun was kind of a bad idea.
Grenades?
I'll see what I can do. Wake up! wake up.
I'm awake. I'm awake. What's your problem?
Our problem.
Sorry, our problem.
That storm knocked out the phone line I used to talk to the service, which means we're cut off. I tried radioing out, and that's not working either. I don't really know why that would be the case. I mean, we've had issues with the radios going out in this area before.
There's no backup?
The backup is the 2-day hike out of here.
So, that's a no?
It's easier for me to send all the lookouts out to check the status of the wire in their areas. Yours is a good hike away. If you find any portion of it down, I can try to get a hold of a ranger and he'll bring someone in to fix it.
Okay, I can do that. Where is it?
Remember that cave you hiked through yesterday?
Yeah, of course.
So, you're gonna want to go back there, go through it, and keep going straight to the north when you come out.
Will do.
Thanks, Hank.
It's Henry.
What, you don't like Hank?
Yeah, I don't like Hank.
But thanks rhymes with Hank.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, all right.
Oh, it's actually pretty damn cold out here.
Roger that. Warms up fast. The mornings are cold in Boulder, though, right?
Yeah, they are.
What did you get up to down there? I mean, what's life like?
I just spend a lot of time with Julia.
Oh, so you have someone there?
Well...
But you're taking a little break, or...
We're...
Look, I'm sorry. Can you hold that thought?
Sure. Just gonna keep hiking and hoping it warms up.
Heyo. I don't think so. Why, have you? Okay, good. No, I don't think he has any idea. I'm absolutely sure. Would you? All right, I'll let you know if anything changes in that regard. Hey, sorry about that. Anyway, Julia, girlfriend? Ex? Sorry, I don't mean to pry.
Who was that?
Who was who?
I don't think he has any idea. What was that? Were you talking about me?
What?
You left your button pressed or something.
Henry, that call was work. I was just talking to... Actually, it's not really your business. Why are you freaking out?
I'm not freaking out.
Good. I'm gonna go quiet for a little bit. Call me if it's important.
Thank you.
Yeah, okay, the wire's down here.
Really? Awesome. Good find.
It's like, I don't know, a mile and a half east of me. You just follow the trail up the hill, you can't miss it. I'll go see what the damage is. Guess what?
What is it?
There's a bunch of empty cans up here.
Same as before?
Yep.
These fucking kids.
How could these girls be so stupid?
Trust me, I never underestimate the stupidity of a drunk teenager. Also, I never underestimate the balls of a drunk young woman, having been one.
I can see the wire you're talking about. It looks like it's in good shape from here.
We'll follow it up to the top of the trail if you can. You can head back as soon as you give me the all clear.
Got it. Hey, so the wire is definitely down out here. I just found it. Yeah, the thing is, it doesn't look like the wind. It looks like it was cut deliberately.
I knew it. The moment you said you found their trash. These idiots are gonna pay. Do they realize this is how people die? I mean, what if something happened to one of my lookouts while this was going on? And God forbid there's an actual fire burning out of control.
What do you want to do?
I want you to go find them.
And then what?
I haven't thought that far ahead. That's not true. Everything that comes to mind is illegal.
Let's hear it.
Oh, yeah?
Hey, I came out here for a breath of fresh air and some adventure. What do you got?
I think I want you to just find them and scare the hell out of them.
Yeah, I'd make a spooky ghost costume, but they stole my sheets.
I don't know. Wait for them to wander off and wreck their camp. Something that would make a teenage girl run home to mommy and daddy.
I'll find them.
Thanks.
But I am gonna need a raise.
Don't hold your breath. I'd start by hiking back towards your tower and just keep an eye out for anything that would lead you to them.
Oh, they're big into Red Eagle.
Great. See if you can find the path they took down from there. Maybe they looped back around towards the lake or something. I doubt they're where they were yesterday, but they obviously can't have gone far.
Hey, I'm out at a ravine. What's this thing that spans across it?
That is how you get to my sector.
No kidding. Well, let me hike over.
Well, it's locked up and mainly for emergencies. I've never actually used it. Rangers use it from time to time, but that's it.
Help! Oh, God, it's an emergency!
Oh, really?
Yeah, I got eyes on a tornado! I gotta get out of here!
A tornado in the heart of the Rockies?
Yes!
Holy moly, I need to call this in! Tom, Two Forks sees a tornado! He says he needs an evac into my sector. It's a meteorological impossibility? There haven't been tornadoes in the greater Yellowstone region in 100 million years? You're gonna need him to stay and take a detailed personal account, even if it means giving his life? Okay, I'll tell him. Sorry, Hank. No dice.
Man. There's an abandoned pack out here.
And it's not one of the teens?
No, it looks like it was lost a long time ago.
Well, you could always pilfer it for supplies.
Well, I am flush with ropes now. That pack was full of them, in decent condition, too.
That's lucky.
I mean, there's enough rope here that I could just leave them hooked up, I think. Oh, get this. This pack came with one of those cardboard single-use cameras.
With pictures left?
Yeah, he only used 3 or 4.
Neato.
Thank you, Brian Goodwin.
Wait, who?
The bag had the name Brian Goodwin sewn into the top. Do you know him?
Yeah, I just haven't heard that name in a few years.
What, was he a fella you had a thing with?
Yeah, it was so hot and heavy. Of course, Brian Goodwin was 12 years old, so, you know, our love could never really be understood.
Ugh.
I'm kidding. Not about him being an actual 12-year-old. That part's true. He was stationed in Two Forks, your lookout, with his dad, Ned, 3 summers ago. Great kid.
You can bring children out here?
No. You know, I'm not a stickler for rules. They took off halfway through the summer.
You guys keep in touch, you and the Goodwin kid?
Nah, they took off pretty unceremoniously. Plus, what's a 40-year-old woman gonna do with a teenage pen pal?
Good point.
Anyway, so it goes. Have fun with that camera. Try not to snap anything that would scar a photo dome employee.
I don't know, I got a lot of hiking to do. Might get bored.
Well, I'm bored as rocks, so I'll keep you company while you find those girls, huh?
Someone found a fossil and put it in a cash box.
Oh, really? Hey, sorry about snapping at you earlier. I thought about it, and yeah, I suppose that must have sounded kind of weird when you heard me take that other call. Plus, you're just out here in your own head. Trust me, I know how it is. So, did you break any hearts back in Colorado when you took this job? I myself have chosen to never get attached to anyone who would miss me, but I know I'm a bit of an outlier. I don't mean that the way it sounds. I mean, I care about people, and I like companionship as much as the next person. But why does it have to come from the same person for your whole life? My Aunt Kathy was married to the same guy for 4 decades, and when he died, she found out he'd been having an affair with a real estate broker for 15 years. Whereas my Aunt Judy traveled the world dating artists and musicians as she saw fit. Call me crazy, but I'd rather spend a week in bed with Sonny Bono than half a lifetime with some cheating stockbroker.
I'm actually married.
But you're here.
It's not really your business.
I'm sorry, but you're the one who brought her up.
Yeah, I did. Sorry.
Whatever, it's fine. Look, I gotta go do a thing downstairs. I'll bring a radio, though.
From this burned section of forest, I have no idea where to go. Their trail is pretty cold at this point.
You're out by Mule Point. No one would camp out in the fireweed. Well, I want you to stay out there, as a favor to little old me.
My pleasure.
Okay, we know these young women are sloppy. They must have left some sort of trail. Getting this fucking flapjack off his ass and out to repair that wire.
Excuse me, flapjack?
You know, like a loser, a chotch.
I really don't, but I do now.
Well, the next time you're at a bar and some banker steps on your foot so he can order his crappy martini, you've got just the name to use.
Hey, flapjack, why don't you wait your turn before I bounce your face off a dumpster?
It's beautiful! Just so you know, I didn't mean to overstep my bounds earlier when you brought up your wife.
I know you didn't. You were just making conversation. I appreciate it.
So, tell me about her, if you want.
She's a college professor. She's a PhD in biology, evolution, and stuff.
Ooh, evolution. That's a risque subject in these parts. Man, she sounds sexy.
She sure was.
Where does she teach?
Boulder.
That's a great school. My cousin went there.
Yeah. Anyway, that's her.
Man, you had a full-on PhD at home. Part of me thinks that would be insufferable, but then there's another part of me that can't help but indulge the whole hot-for-teacher thing. You know, heavy petting in the book stacks, furtive glances during lecture, office hours role-play. But Professor, I can't fail chemistry. Isn't there anything I can do to pass the class, Oh, God, I think the second part's winning. Well, I called to ask about her, but now I think I've entertained myself plenty. Thanks. Well, I called to ask about her, but now I think I've entertained myself plenty. Thanks.
We had a lot of fun.
I bet you did. Did she wear glasses the whole nine?
No, she had 20/20 vision. I don't know. She's Australian, so.
What's that supposed to mean?
I wore shoes and showered, and when I got drunk, I didn't fight half the town.
Mm-hmm. And how often was that?
We had a lot of fun. I get the sense that not everything in here is useful.
In the boxes? Why's that?
I don't really know what I'll do with the deer horn.
Firstly, they're called antlers. And secondly, stay out here long enough and you'll get creative.
Ah!
All kidding aside, what happened with the professor? If you guys had so much fun, when did it stop?
When she got sick, that's when it stopped?
Oh, my God, fuck, what happened?
We can talk about it later.
See that?
Yeah, I think so. That thin plume of smoke?
Yeah. Looks like it's way down to the southwest. You should be able to find a way over there from the meadow by the lake. Towards Five Mile Creek. It's in the southwest quadrant of your map.
What, you think it's those girls?
I'm pretty sure it's a campfire, so yeah. I'd call that a safe bet.
Man, they really do not give a shit, do they?
Not a one. Was she?
Is she? She's alive. She's with her family in Melbourne, Australia. She's 43.
Fuck.
Yeah.
What was it like when you guys found out?
Okay, I have eyes on that smoke plume.
Great. Find your way over there and give them hell.
We were scared shitless. We went straight to the doctor after her first spell or whatever. They diagnosed her, and we were both just very scared. Can't really tell when Julia is scared. She just gets quiet. She was very quiet.
So, how'd you meet?
Met in a bar.
The birthplace of modern romance.
I stumbled over and told her she was pretty, and that was it.
Aw, you were brave.
I was drunk. How many hikers go missing in the Shoshone?
More than none, unfortunately, with most of them being in this area. The thoroughfare, because it's so remote. Why?
I found an old flyer for a missing hiker. It just got me thinking, that's all. Like how you said one day you were talking to the Goodwins, and then the next you weren't.
Ned Goodwin didn't get mauled by a bear or stuck in a ravine. He was just a PTSD'd a-hole who dragged his son out to do a job and realized it was a bad idea.
PTSD? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, I don't know. He was in the army. He was off. It's actually the saddest story. He was only discharged because his mother, Brian's grandmother, died. She'd been taking care of him, and Ned was the only next of kin.
Damn. And you got to know Brian a little bit?
Yeah. I talked to him way more than I'd talked to Ned, that's for sure.
How was he at, spotting fires?
Better than you. He actually liked to stay in the tower.
Boy, for as dry as it is this summer, there's an area down here that's lush.
Oh, you must be talking about the Aspen Grove down there.
Yeah, I think that's where I am.
Those trees are actually one root organism. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Yeah, they share their water as a colony that can live for hundreds of years, even through fire. Can you believe you're actually getting paid to learn all of these amazing things? Also, by what it looks like on this map, you'll be coming up on a stream that should lead you towards where we saw that smoke.
There's some cloth out here. It looks like it was torn from something.
Strange.
I'll keep looking around. It's a really nice waterfall down here. Given those girls love a skinny dipping, I bet they're nearby. Campsite, and it looks like they've got a fire.
Is it them?
No, it seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
Track them down, and don't let them see you.
What a job this is. I have entered the teen zone.
Oh, really? And where's that?
It's the name of a magazine for girls. It's on the ground here at their camp. Well, I found some dangerous hunks.
What on earth are you...
It's another one of those magazines. These girls have a full case of beer left here. A full case.
Well, they're impressive little shits, I guess.
That is some dedication. Their tent looks like it's been through the shredder, which would explain that scrap I found.
What could have done that? Like a bear or, I don't know, it sounds crazy, but even a bull elk if it's off its rocker.
Whatever did it, did not hold back.
You've got that camera, right? It might be a good idea to get a few snaps, just in case.
Yeah, good thinking. Looks like someone left a note.
Intriguing. Maybe you should read it.
Okay, yeah.
Let me know what it says.
Oh, they're gone, for sure.
Well, what's it say?
I'm threatening to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well, did you?
Don't be ridiculous.
It's not ridiculous. I've known you, what, 24 hours? Maybe you're nuts.
God, look, I just came out here to sit in a tower, all right? Not... get into some mess with a bunch of co-eds.
It's fine. They're gone?
Yeah, they're gone. But you should see this place. It's just... it's weird.
weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know. But they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back. And we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Henry?
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
I could be Tom Cruise's good-looking twin brother.
Oh, that's too bad. I read in People he's like 5'0".
Yeah, well, you can't win them all.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear? Now, this can't be that hard. Think of your closet. Open it in your mind. What is inside?
I don't know. I like to look nice, usually. Well, I try now, I guess.
Had a bit of a schlubby period, did we?
Yeah, a good 25, 30 years, yeah.
But, now you'll put on a clean shirt?
Yeah, well, I have one that I got for Christmas, actually. Just, it's navy with white buttons, but I like it. I don't wear it that much, though.
Well, it sounds just perfect. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
A pretty thick beard.
Oh, have you always had a beard?
For a while, yeah.
All right, perfect. I want to know about your eyes.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
You're what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
They're happy, I think. I mean, I've been told they look happy.
Julia told you that, huh?
Look, I don't know how to describe eyes.
Happy is good. That's good. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.